God our Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everybody. We call to mind our sins as we ask God for pardon and strength. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you gave yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Be present to your family, O Lord, we pray, and graciously ensure those you have endowed with the grace of faith an eternal share in the resurrection of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. There broke out a severe persecution of the church in Jerusalem, and all were scattered throughout the countryside of Judea and Samaria, except the apostles. Devout men buried Stephen and made a loud lament over him. Saul, meanwhile, was trying to destroy the church, entering house after house and dragging out men and women to be handed over for imprisonment. Now those who had been scattered went about preaching the word. Thus Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowd paid attention to what was said by Philip. When they heard it and saw the signs that he was doing, for unclean spirits crying out in a loud voice came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed and crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Shout joyfully to God, all the earth. Sing praise to the glory of his name. Proclaim his glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous are your deeds.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all on earth worship and sing praise to you. Sing praise to your name. Come and see the works of God, his tremendous deeds among the children of Adam.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
He has changed the sea into dry land. Through the river they passed on foot. Therefore, let us rejoice in him. He rules by his might forever.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to God.
Jesus said to the crowds, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. But I told you that although you have seen me, you do not believe. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I will raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Just heard Jesus sharing a hopeful message in our gospel from the writer John. We continue to meander through the Bread of Life discourse. He has been sent that I should not lose anything of what he, the Father, gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. Even amid tragedy, even amid the struggles that we face every day, no one can be truly lost if he or she comes to Jesus. For the people of the Acts of the Apostles, this must have been a great consolation. Not only had they just buried Stephen, a great preacher and a leader in their community, they now find themselves persecuted. How lost they must have felt with the mission under siege. How lost we feel when our dreams crumble and it feels as though we are running for our lives. Jesus offers the comfort to know that if we go to him, we will never be lost, and that he will raise us up and make us whole again. But of course, Jesus has not come merely to protect victims and hold up the righteous. One thing that we can never forget is that he came for the sinner, those who are truly lost. Look what he did with Saul, who persecuted the church. Jesus saved him as well. He was not truly lost, and he too was raised up. This is certainly not only a challenge to us, but also a daily reminder that even our persecutors and our enemies are loved and sought after by the Lord. With confidence and trust, we join together in offering our prayers to God for ourselves and our world. For the church, that God's plan for salvation may come to fruition in every corner of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who lead and govern, that God's wisdom may guide them in charity and integrity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those oppressed for their religious views, may the Lord rescue them and comfort them in their affliction. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the needs of the Crofton community, that the peace and hope of Christ may reign in every heart, every relationship, and in every neighborhood. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died recently or will die today, that they may come to know Jesus' promise of eternal life with them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parishioners, for whom we remember especially at this Mass, and for what or for whom do we pray for today?
For all those who have received our blessed prayer, show us that they may be comforted. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The victims of the school shooting in Colorado, let us pray for them.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, we ask that you hear and answer our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice and yours.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, as we sing together the hymn of your glory. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna.
O Lord, you are indeed holy. You are the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks, he gave it to his friends and said, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, save the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you exist. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, your people spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy and religious. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
We pray the words that Christ taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith and courage of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are we called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
thank you. most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day, everybody.